John 7. A large part of being a Christian is to receive the Spirit of Jesus. Now, I don't refer to miraculous gifts, speaking in tongues or languages, raising the dead, doing miracles and stuff. I refer to the Spirit in the sense of the mind, the disposition, the way of thinking of Jesus. This is absolutely critical. Paul later says that if we are lacking the Spirit of Christ, then we are not his at all. We are none of his. We're simply people who know some theology, some Bible verses, and nothing more. We so need him to live within us by his Spirit. This is what it is to be a Christian. And so here in John 7, 37 to 39, Jesus clearly predicts this. Jesus stood and cried, saying, "If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He that believes on me, as the scripture has said, from within him, from his innermost being, shall flow rivers of living water." He spoke of the Spirit which they that believed in him were to receive. For the Spirit had not yet been received, as Jesus had not yet been glorified. So, from out of our innermost beings, there will flow a river of living water. I think Jesus had in mind those Old Testament prophecies of the Messianic temple. Out of that temple, there were to flow rivers of living waters, which gave life to the dead world around them. Green trees and plants sprung up because of those waters, and all was healed. And this, Jesus is saying, is what can happen in our experience right now. For those around us, we can have this impact upon them. Now, man is never better than when he is being some real help to others. It's the most amazing thing to be used by God and Jesus to transform the lives of others, to help an alcoholic or drug addict to quit, to get sober, to become full of life and joy in Christ, and guide them towards the eternal life of God's kingdom. That is an experience that no money can buy. That is better than any smart house or expensive holiday where you sit in a hotel enjoying yourself. No, to help others to transform, that is priceless. But how can we do this? In our own strength, we cannot. We need the Spirit of Jesus. So I encourage you to keep on praying both to God and to Jesus to fill you with their Spirit and to make you a source of that Spirit to others. Now, God is not a bank machine. You don't just tap in a secret code and money pours out. Not at all. He's far more subtle and wonderful than that. But I suggest that these simple prayers for the Spirit and to be a source of the Spirit to others will definitely be heard. Maybe not immediately, but soon they will be heard. And indeed, you will say along with me, "This is the life, and there's no other life like it."